Hi, we're Toronto Met Robotics, and we're proud to introduce our rover for URC 2025, Orion.
This year, the mechanical team's main focus was to improve the reliability of existing components and reduce excess weight. The gear ratio of the cycloidal gearbox at the arm shoulder has also been increased from 15 to 1 to 25 to 1. This allows for a higher torque output, improving stability and load-bearing capabilities of the arm. New magnetic encoders are being implemented into the elbow, shoulder, and wrist joints of our 5-degree of freedom arm. The exact positioning of the arm will be tracked through these encoders, allowing for a more precise and accurate control during missions. We have also lightened our parallel and adaptive gripper designs while maintaining their strength, switching the adaptive gripper to worm drive for anti-back drive ability.
To cut down on excess weight, tension cable spoke wheels will be used in place of bulky PET G-rings. In addition, various drivetrain components, such as motor mounts and suspension plates, have been optimized, increasing their strength to weight ratio. Modifications to the chassis have also been made to allow for a more seamless integration of electronics, as well as load-bearing components.
This year, the software team focused on unifying the software stack, with a focus on building expandable systems. ROS2 has been integrated into our TNC microcontrollers, NVIDIA Jetson, and base station computers. This system allows for all devices on the network to access important data, including motor controller status, joint positions, and wheel velocities. Running ROS on a microcontroller allows only a significant code to run, while not including any unnecessary drivers or libraries, further contributing to our goal of ease of testing. Implementing ROS2 allowed for our web team to develop a new Rover dashboard, web apps that combine the Control, Auton, and Science dashboards. This unified dashboard allows the technical leads to see if any system is down, while the drivers can focus on the information important to them.
Our new camera system comprises of 9 cameras, 6 of which are streaming at any given time simultaneously. With H.264 encoded streams over UDP using GStreamer, we reduced latency and network overhead. A new software stack built on GTK3 and TCP sockets provides a flexible and organized interface with high reliability. Users can control the bitrate, resolution, toggle cameras, and more directly on the GUI on the fly, allowing adaptation to different missions and network conditions.
This year, for the autonomous mission, our team has migrated from using custom ROS2 package to the open source NAV2 package for a more reliable navigation. With NAV2, we are able to generate local cost maps using point cloud data from a Z2i stereo camera to help with short-term and long-term path planning. Odometry and RTK differential GPS are fused for localization and centimeter accuracy positioning. Additionally, the autonomous system now uses a Jetson Orin Nano, which will help with faster and more accurate detection in our Aruko and object detection system.
Our main goals for the electrical team this year was to increase the efficiency and safety of our power distribution and control systems. We've slimmed down to a single battery power system. This, along with our quick release mechanism, allows us to quickly and safely change batteries. We've also created custom shock absorbing cases for our batteries to prevent shock damage and punctures. To decrease the risk of damage to our electrical system, we've added current monitoring to our power distribution system. This will allow us to detect any abnormal power draws and quickly remedy the issue before damage can be done to the battery or other components. The current monitoring system will work in conjunction with the auto resetting breakers integrated into our power distribution board.
This year, we've also moved to a fully modular control system, comprising of a main compute board and various peripheral boards.
Each peripheral board allows us to add functionality without having to redevelop our entire control system. The rover itself, ARM, and Science Console all have their own modular board stack.
This year, the science team has focused on developing a robust science console capable of performing in-situ analysis at various test sites for life detection and habitability.
Building upon last year's soil collection system, auger size has been reduced to half an inch diameter, accompanied by a much higher motor torque. Upon collection, the sample is loaded onto one of three stations, the self-closing cache to submit to the judges, the lipid assay, or the iron probe array, with soil samples being transported through a series of custom-made peristaltic pumps to their designated locations.
For life detection, we have decided to implement an enhanced version of our lipid assay from last year. This improved protocol utilizes NALBU for staining and hexane for efficient lipid extraction and solubilization. Measurements at 540 nanometers and 640 nanometers are then obtained via spectrophotometry to determine the ratio of neutral to acidic lipids in the sample. Additionally, this year we have designed our very own 3D printed ion probe array to detect the presence of key ions such as potassium, calcium, and hydrogen. This array is crucial for understanding the habitability of the soil. To support the mission's objectives, our enhanced camera system will help capture high-resolution panoramic images of the test site, in addition to providing clear images for stratigraphic profiling and geological analysis of both the test site and any rock samples present on site.
We're excited to put our hard work to the test and push the limit of what our rover can do at URC 2025. This journey wouldn't have been possible without the incredible support of our sponsors. Thank you for your support and watching our system acceptance review video.